Welcome students, in this video we are going to see the hypoeutectic transformation. The previous video we have seen the eutectic, now we are seeing the hypoeutectic transformation. So, dear students, we are having here the eutectic point, okay. So, from this eutectic, from 0% up to this, this is the hypoeutectic region, and up to this extreme right, we are having from eutectic, that is a hypereutectic, and this point we are having the eutectic. So we have seen the eutectic transformation, how the microstructure will look in the eutectic, that is a layer by layer lamellar structure, isn't it? Now we are interested in this hypoeutectic region, and then we will go for this hypereutectic transformation. To have that, let us see, dear students, we have to consider the region from this to the left. So this is the hypoeutectic region. So that is the reason why let us consider the line in the hypoeutectic region. Say somewhere here I am assuming this line, okay, and if you see, this line is the liquidus line. So above this everything is liquid, isn't it? So I am saying that, say this here, so everything is liquid, but on this line, say this temperature is, say it is TL, and we know this is the eutectic line having the temperature T, okay. And again, please, I am saying that in general, we are looking for this transformation, that is in element A and B. Need not to consider the exact values here. Okay, in general, we are talking about. So, dear students, so if we see above this line, so above this liquidus line, so everything is what? It is liquid, isn't it? Now, if we drop the temperature just below, the temperature just below the TL, so in this region, we are now dropping the temperature just below this TL temperature. So what is going to happen, or what the thing you are going to see here? So if we drop the temperature just below the, or just slightly below this TL, so alpha is going to nucleate, dear students. Say I'm showing here, somehow the alpha is going to be nucleated. As this region is rich in A, definitely by default, dear students, alpha will nucleate, isn't it? So just below this line, the alpha is getting nucleated, isn't it? And how it is get nucleated and it will grow like? So very interestingly, dear students, the very common structure for the growth, that is the dendrite, dendritic structure, or dendrite. Dendrite is a tree-like structure. It is again a Greek word, tree-like structure. Most of the casted product will show this dendritic microstructure. So the very simple to form, also very simple to nucleate and grow, that is the dendritic, very common structure. So as soon as we drop this temperature below this TL, the alpha is going to be nucleated and it start growing in the dendritic fashion or dendritic manner. So it will start growing. It will start growing in the dendritic form. It will start growing in the dendritic form. From where? So from this point below this up to the point just above this TE. So from the here to here, this alpha will nucleate and grow in the form of dendrite, and it will grow. It will grow up to this T. Isn't it? Say just above the T, the structure will be something like this, where you can observe the alpha, it is in well grown condition. Say this is the alpha, this is the alpha, this is the alpha. Okay. Now this is the alpha which is grown in the dendritic manner, dear students, and we cannot forget that just below the TE, what is there? The alpha and beta are present in the form of lamellae, that is laminar or slab of alpha and beta. Alpha and beta are already existing below T. So if you look at, if we drop the temperature below this T again, so from here to here, which is grown? Alpha is grown in a dendritic fashion like this. Now below that, this already we have seen in eutectic fashion, the alpha and beta are grown in the layer by layer structure like this. Now I am showing only this, I will not you choose the color, but layer by layer region mein kya hai yahan pe, alpha and beta, they are present. So dear students, let me finish it so that you can get it nicely. So see here students, so again in this layer by layer, suppose black color is alpha and white thickness is showing the beta. So dear students, so just below the T already the alpha is present in the lamellar form with the beta, and above T up to TL, the already alpha is grown in the dendritic fashion, dear students. So please remember that here the alpha which is present here, there are two alphas, which is present in the dendritic fashion and which is present in the layer by layer fashion, there are two alpha. So dear students, the alpha which has been nucleated and grown from this region to this region, this is our alpha which is grown before this eutectic alpha, isn't it? So that is the reason why this alpha is known as the primary alpha, or this is also known as the pro-eutectic alpha. Pro-eutectic alpha, dear students, please remember this. This is this dendritic form mein jo bhi न्यूक्लिएट होके ग्रो हुआ अल्फा है वो क्या है, प्राइमरी अल्फा है, और उसको क्या कहते हैं, प्रोयूटेक्टिक अल्फा कहते हैं, विच इज इन डेंड्रिटिक मैनर, एंड बिलो टी विच इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन द लैमिनार फॉर्म विद द बीटा, दिस अल्फा इज नोन एज यूटेक्टिक अल्फा, दिस इज द यूटेक्टिक अल्फा. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द microstructure you can see, or this is the evolved microstructure in case of hyper-eutectic system or hyper-eutectic transformation. Understood? So this is, dear students, about the hypo-eutectic. It's not the hyper in this range, it is a hypo. More than eutectic, it is hypo. Less than eutectic, it is hypo, and more than eutectic, it is hyper. So this transformation we discussed, it was the hypo-eutectic transformation. Thank you so much.